life a legend, no. And I have followed your work, looked at every single video and read everything about you and what Dr. Hande has done. You would wish that a lot of other people are able to do, reach out to rural areas and people who are not served by technology, and we try to understand, find solutions, help them out. So that's why he's one of my heroes.
No, madam.
He's actually gone to that and made difference to 450,000.
Yeah, a little about 500.
Yes, 500,000 households. So it's a very big number that his company Selco has been able to serve and take electricity and solve their problems, build technology around their needs. So we are very honored that Harish is with us today, and let's hear from him.
No, thank you.
Thank you.
No, thank you. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Can you hear me fully? No, thank you for inviting me. And ma'am has been. I'm a very inefficient planner, and ma'am thinks I'm very busy. There's a very thin line between busyness and inefficiencies, and so I travel with a great inefficiency that and it's been after some time that I've been to Delhi, and last time I spoke at IIT Delhi, and then she said, you got to come and speak to this group. It's nothing, please interrupt any time. It's just an experience of what myself have gone through. It's nothing extraordinary. It's just that it's a way of life in terms of what this country offers, and what this country offers not only from an Indian perspective, and for me, there's nothing called as nationalism, Indian passport, and this. I mean, that's very much a, what do you call it? We are all anti-nationals as long as poverty exists in this country. So this whole talk about why, if an American NRI tells me what is nationalism, the moment you pledged your alliance to get an American passport, you are an anti-national in one way or the other, right? But that's different in a sense that today we deal with. IIT, so I went to IIT Kharagpur, as I keep saying that, because 300 million Indians did not write the exam. If they had written that entrance exam, I would not have got into IIT, plain and simple. And so we are in a very exclusive, way where we are at a running race where we are at 50 meters and others are at minus 50 and say we have won the race, which is completely non-inclusive, unfair. And society is unfair because a country like India lives on the subsidies of the poor. The poor subsidize us. Whether you have a maid servant, whether you're drivers, we don't pay their market salaries. We live on their subsidies so that we increase our savings and earnings. Right? So there are 650 million of us who we think are supposed to be our labor force. Nothing else. They are philosophers, they are explorers, they are scientists. They can be given the same opportunity that you and me had. So let's not pat in our backs that we are from IIT and anything else, because we have created exclusive systems that only certain of us can get into IIT. That's the purity of the systems we are. And so as ma'am was saying that, how do we inspire students? I said, first is how do we inspire professors to teach differently to actually solve the problems of this country, rather than taking it how the students can actually change. I think first let's look at professors. I have had issues with IIT Kharagpur, IIT Madras, BMS College professors, how do they change their teaching process before you look at what the problems are in many cases? Because I've had horrendous experiences. Because see, issue is when we started, and I started in looking at sustainability in 1990, when graduated from IIT Kharagpur, where I saw a lot of places where walking up to this place, IIT Delhi. I hated IIT Delhi because they beat us in hockey many, many years ago when I played IIT versus IIT Delhi. Coming back, I saw ragging is banned. That was banned in Kharagpur also. So we had orientation. So everybody was oriented. So because ragging was banned, so you couldn't use the word ragging. The question, I got oriented by Arvind Kejriwal, and Sundar Pichai was my kiddo in terms of staying for 3 years in the hostel. So more than what we studied, obviously, in IIT Kharagpur, more what we did in the hostel was more important, which actually led to the many of the thinking processes for quite a bit of us during that generation, even later on, saying that the society in terms of there are so many problems and solutions, right? Today, I mean, if you look at 2 weeks, 3 weeks ago, India was number 100 in terms of hunger statistics out of 117 and 131 in the Human Development Index out of 172. We are very happy because Pakistan is 137. So what has the IITs contributed? Zero, zip, nothing. If the same subsidies that ITIs in this country got it, this country could have been a greater nation. Because what has so many engineering schools, medical schools, colleges, that we are 137th in the world or 31st in the world in the Human Development Index? So what if you are the second largest economy in the world? It matters nothing. You know the Human Development Index of parts of Orissa or parts of Bihar, Orissa, less like South Orissa, 0.15. Sierra Leone is 0.4. Sierra Leone's HDI index is much better than parts of Orissa. South Sudan has a better HDI index than parts of Meghalaya and Bihar. So when we look at countries like that, oh, they're very poor and this and that. With a country like India, with so many engineering schools, that you have the head of Microsoft and head of Google running, coming from this country, absolutely zero outputs or inputs to the basic issues, not only from an Indian perspective, that what you do in India, what you do in Orissa, is highly applicable in Ethiopia. What you do in Manipur is highly applicable in Djibouti. The area of area of Manipur is 22,000 square kilometers. Area of Djibouti is 22,000 square kilometers. 1 million population, 2.6. Lot of the innovations that you do in Manipur is highly applicable in Djibouti in Ethiopia. But what do? We're 100 in hunger statistics. Our water issue is absolutely in a mess. My question is, you can keep talking of negativities. I can only speak of negativity in this in our own country when you have such a talent, and what is the talent doing? So when one of the professors who was a former IAS officer of head of Ministry of Renewable Energy, he said, "Boss, you've had tough time with your professors over the years, but now I give you a chance to give them a tough time. So potential IIT directors who can become directors in the next 5 years of IITs and an IIT case, I have 40 of them in a room like this in IIT Bombay, come and talk to them. Now it's your chance to orient or act them or whatever." So I asked you all potential who've been in the IIT system for 30 years, 25 years, tell me one innovation that IITs have done that has changed rural India. I don't want two, I need one. None of them could answer one. So do we deserve the subsidy that the government of India gives or not? There are issues in this country. There are the excitement of working in a country like India is that it is a paradox of a world where we have overdeveloped and underdeveloped countries. We become the superpower of solutions for the rest of the world to actually follow. But why are we not doing it? I mean, I told this example last time when I was in IIT Delhi. We have an innovation lab in one of the rural areas where two women came in and said, "We heard you solve problems," which is kind of a scary question for a lot of us. And I had two of my colleagues, and they said, "We only want to talk to the women colleagues." They said, we have two saris, and it gets drenched during the monsoons, and we have not, and it doesn't dry. Because it doesn't dry, the fungus grows on it. And because of fungus, the body smells and my husband cheats on me." And both of them collapsed in the floor saying that, "Please save our marriage." Your Google search goes out of the window. Your PhD goes out of the window. How can you come up with solutions where it's raining, there's no electricity, come up with drying options for the women to dry their saris? Similar issue in Gujarat, where marriages break down because there's no water and the body smells and the relationship between man and husband and wife does not happen. Because these are basic issues of our country. There's nothing of mapping of those problems, forget solutions. Right? So there are three useless degrees I have, bachelor's from IIT and master's and PhD. I absolutely never made any sense for me because when started fieldwork in 92-93, I had to unlearn what I had learned because I was taught in a way that you are so-called superior intellectually. Because we confuse between financial poverty and intellectual poverty. All of us sitting here did a PhD on sugarcane. We are all experts of sugarcane. A farmer doing 40 years of sugarcane will never be called an expert because he or she does not have a PhD. And he'll have to sit there and listen to a PhD who has done in sugarcane, who have absolutely no clue even to grow one sugarcane. Right? Why have we created such a non-inclusive system as a society where we are not even able to articulate the problems properly, but we have come directly, we know what the solutions are. So what we do is we come up with a set of solutions and we try to fit the problem. And that's what the kind of society we have created in the system that we have, whether it's IITs or whether it's any other education system. So we said, boss, this is something crazy in terms of hitting hard, because you know my parents were born, I was born and brought up in, though I'm a Kannadiga, born and brought up in Orissa, where my father didn't have to pay for electricity bills in state in the steel city of Rourkela. Went to IIT, subsidized education, got a scholarship, got master's and PhD. So I'm basically a product of subsidy standing in front of you. And then I'll go and talk about market economics, how, you know, subsidies, blah, 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 etc. And that is what the IIMs and the IITs have done in many ways, right? So went to the US with just like a GRE, the whole funda of in the hostels and the herd mentality of writing GRE. Went to the US to think, okay, let's do large solar, how can it help? Had a chance to go to Dominican Republic in 91. And in that place, there was a farmer called Martinez who basically went inside the house and switched on the lights and switched off the lights three or four times and said, see, this light, you know, I control it. It's run on solar. Nobody else can say when I cannot have the light. And I learned it, you know, from where he said. He said the concept of decentralization, didn't it come from your country, what Mahatma Gandhi said about. The guy who's 10,000 miles away is telling me no so-called education, according to our definition of what education actually means, telling me what decentralization was. He said, but Vanna, I have an issue with you Indians. You Indians have helped Europe, have helped America greatly. But whenever I meet an Indian, he or she always complains. This has not happened, that at all, and always will say somebody else should do it, the government should do it. Never takes the responsibility on oneself to actually say that I will be the solution provider. And that you hits you in reality, that hits you in the sense that is true. And he said, boss, the greatest thing to Dominican Republic, we will not get help from America or Europe. If you Indians actually started looking at sustainability and poverty reduction in your own country, that will help nations like Dominican Republic. And so that, I mean, go back, you went back to the US, my love for mathematics and thermodynamics just flew out of the window. I told my professor that I really can't do this anymore. I want to do something that is, I don't want to do a thesis that it will be in somebody's library with absolutely no value. Let me go, because I have not felt what it means to be without electricity. What it means socially, emotionally, the thought process of what it means. So, came back to Sri Lanka in India, and Sri Lanka, why I chose first was because I was not sure whether I could go to rural India and where people would treat me the same way, because unfortunately I had a stupid education and people will treat me at a different level. And once you don't know a language, like in Sri Lanka, people treat you the same way. Oh, well, he doesn't know the language, so he's as illiterate as in a different manner. But due to the LTT chaos in 92, 93, came back. And then 2 years without one form of energy or not, but not focusing on solar, but just the way of life in terms of people, in terms of, you know, I mean, things that teach you in many ways. I was having a solar exhibition where I was in a place there were 30, 40 or 100 shops for 17 days. So I was doing this solar TV and an exhibition. I had no money. It was 1,000 rupees a month that I had a scholarship for. And then night I would sleep in the stall because you had no money to hire somebody else. And all the other laborers of other stalls would come to my stall because I had a solar power TV. And I became great friends with 17 of them. Absolutely great friends. No qualms, have no clue. On the 17th day, I had two of my friends who came from the US. And then started speaking to the left, and these 17 guys came up and said, how do you know them? I said, I know them, they're friends. They said, you are educated. And 2 seconds, I lost 17 friends. Suddenly they said, sorry, sir, humne aisa baat kiya. What? Just an education became a barrier for me that I lost 17 friends in 5 seconds because somebody visited me? It's just unfair. Completely unfair of a society because we created that barrier in a country like ours. When you go up and become parts of different companies and organizations, right? The way we treat somebody who's financially poor is just unacceptable without looking at the guys are intellectually smart. Whether it's a guard who is at IIT Delhi, whether it's a driver who is an auto rickshaw driver, they're not because they have a choice. That's a living, boss. You can actually have a concrete discussions with them in many ways. But why have we demarcated ourselves in any IIT as a boundary that it's a bubble or any society, middle class, anything else? And that shocked to the same boss, this is absolutely crazy. I mean, this is, went and bought all my 3 certificates, master's, bachelor's and PhD. I do not have any certificate, I do not have a grade certificate. Boss, we'll create an organization which will not look at degrees. We'll create an organization which will not look at resumes. And we said, boss, do you have the passion? Do you have the common sense to be part of an organization which we really want to look at? An organization that destroys the myth that the poor can't afford technologies, the poor can't maintain technologies, and the third is you can't run a commercial venture while trying to meet social objectives, commercial in a sustainable manner, not in terms of profitability or everything else. So we started with two of my colleagues way back in 1993, 94 mid, and these two colleagues of mine were TV technicians in the repairing old TVs during that time of 90s. And you know, once you take, and they left their jobs to join me and with absolutely no idea what's going to happen because solar was unknown. And if you leave a job in the village that point of time, anybody would fill in. And who sacrificed more, me or them, right? They were 10th grade dropouts. Oh, IIT's ka hai, bahar se, you came back from America. You didn't sacrifice, you had a choice. These guys left without knowing what's going to happen. I had 1,000 rupees, 300, 300, 300, each of us divided between three parts. Second installation we had. So we would take a 1 week credit from a supplier and say, boss, I'll pay you back. So first we wanted to put solar system into rich people's house so that it becomes a demo around who can pay us cash because we had nothing else. Second house, ginger farmer. We put up the system, three of us, installed it, evening 7 o'clock. At 7 o'clock, he tells us that this year my ginger didn't happen. I'll give money after after a month. Complete shocker because we needed that money to go and pay to the supplier, get another system of 14,000 rupees so we could do the third farmer. Three of us went to the bus station in Madikeri. I had 20 bucks in my 20 rupees in my pocket. Spent it all. We were hungry. We ate, frustrated. Realized that none of us had money to go back to Mangalore. You know, two of my colleagues, the three of us, I was the most, I mean, two dropouts and one PhD. Guess who was the most useless one? They told me, please sit down. They worked as coolies for 2 hours in the bus. Made enough money for me to get back to Mangalore, us to get Mangalore, in the bus telling me that how Selco will survive. Now tell me who has sacrificed. Right? That's the talent that exists in this country. And those guys are still here. I mean, if you come to Selco as an organization today, there are 600. We don't take resumes. If you come to the management meeting, you will not know whether somebody is an All India number 2 chartered accountant, somebody who is a 10th grade dropout, or who is an MIT grad. I bet you will not be able to find out who is MIT, who is London School of Economics, who is 10th grade, who is 4th grade, who is All India number 2 chartered accountant. Because they report to each other above. The MIT person reports to the 10th grade dropout, and it's been there for 10, 15 years. Salaries of the MIT is less than the 10th grade dropout, and multiple of them. Why should somebody get higher salary just because you're from IIT or MIT? You had the privilege of going there, but you don't have the privilege of doing as much work in the ground. And that's when we said, boss, a lot of people said idealism, idealism. Idealism kya hota hai? You have to break those egos and break the stereotypes and break the way the society behaves and see that unfortunately we are known for solar. Solar is just one part of it as a sustainability that we believe that solar is where we do work. Yes, and that's we build on. But how do you create an organization that builds on the philosophy of how society should be? Because for us, business mirrors society and vice versa. We cannot be separated and different. That's why I don't believe in the concept of social entrepreneurship. We are entrepreneurships and others are antisocial. And that's what we think. It's because why shouldn't every business be part of society, and why the special category of social entrepreneurship per se? So that's where we created. Now there are 600 of us in Selco. We also structured it in a manner that, boss, how do you, we have shareholders, three shareholders, 100% they own the organization. And the management is now, I left the active management in 2014. We have 60 offices. It's been profitable from last 12 years. A lot of people say we are communist, we are leftist, we are great to be called as left at communist. But if you think Ola and Uber, the largest not-for-profits in the world, Uber is the largest not-for-profit in the world. Never make money, ever. But it's a market company, right? Loses $1 billion a quarter, but we all clap and say how great in terms of what it's going to happen. And then we defeat the other potential entrepreneurship that happens that are struggling and making sustainability the true course in many ways, economic sustainability or financial or environmental sustainability. So what we said was, so I left 2014. So my colleague who runs it is Mohan, who joined Selco into 1998-99 as an office assistant in Kumta office. I have no idea what his qualification is. Grew up to be the CEO of the organization. And when he speaks Kannada, there are Swamijis who don't speak if Mohan speaks first, because his purity of Kannada is so high. Just, and we make him feel inferior because he doesn't know English. Who gets the money? PowerPoint, Excel, and Word. Non-English speakers have no chance in this country. Absolutely. Tell me, in a country like ours with 1.2, 1.3 billion people, only two, like Lijjat Papad or Baba Ramdev, tell me one other non-English speaking corporate head in this country. Zip. China, you get it. France, you get it. Italy, you get it. Why not in India? How can we create a language as a qualification? Right? That's something, fundamentally, there's something wrong in the way we look at society per se. And so Selco said, boss, no resumes. Where do you have it? So we have 60 offices providing energy access to underserved households, where we believe that each and every person has the ability to pay, have respect, provided you are able to come up with solutions that fit the problem that they have in a manner. But first you have to be very sure, are you able to understand the needs of the poor in the manner that you're yourself that person? And how are you able to be that person to actually say, so when you say that, how are you going to give a solution? You have to give a solution as if you're giving a solution to your father or sister. Every client is that way for you, father or a sister, right? And that's why I'm very, very proud to say one of my technician colleagues who got married, 200 clients came for the wedding. And for, because the clients felt that one of them was getting married, and because he had provided solutions to people in their individual households as if it's his own system. So you design the system and pricing according to what the people would afford, talk to the bank and create the appropriate financial product that would match their cash flows. Simple thing. A lot of these people, like there's a colleague of mine who was sitting in one of the areas, and then an auto rickshaw driver comes in and says, I want a three light system. Knowing that a three light system, he can't afford a three light system. He said, boss, I know you need three light system, but I'll come to your house. He came to, went to the house, figured it out, said, had he given the cost of the three light, the auto rickshaw driver would have gone that day. What he did was, this guy broke up the top of the roof, put one light. He said he needed light in three rooms. He didn't need three lights. The end value was light in three rooms. It's not about putting three lights. How do you relook at the demand? Or for example, they would go to a tomato vendor and say it's white light. Because under a white light, the tomato is redder. Banana vendor, it's yellow light. Because under the yellow light, the spots of a banana are less visible. Same thing in potato. How do you come up and are able to, it's not about solar lighting. Are you able to see what the needs are and able to customize the system according to those needs? and more the best way form to get it, unless you don't feel it, it's very difficult to come up with those solutions. A lot of like some, and there are, I mean, this gets more and more complex. Like some of my colleagues did a brilliant strategy of how do you reach out providing solar to people who earn less than 800 rupees a month, right? And they said, boss, what is the need? Why do people need it? They need 4 hours of lighting so that children get educated, so they don't have to go through the same issue that they went through. And so what they did was they put solar panels on the school. They put light and battery at home, battery being less than the weight of a lunchbox. The kid comes to the school to charge into the school's charging station. If she doesn't come to school, there's no light at home. So she has to come to the school to charge her battery so that light is there at home. So the mother says, boss, you go to school because I need the light at night. Right? Now A plus B plus C, A is a coal-fired plant, B is the transmission lines, C is your house, A is the school, B is the kid, C is the house. A plus B could be an entrepreneur delivery. You can have a mathematical equation of A plus B plus C and do a permutation and combination of A plus B plus C of what models, of what delivery, what services. It could work for water, it could work for basic livelihoods, it could for rice milling, it could for electricity. You can actually work, and that is the wonders that our educational system should produce, is the multicultural, what you call it, the diversity of problem solving. You're not a mechanical engineer, you're not an electrical engineer. Are you a solution provider? The moment you say that I'm a mechanical engineer, I don't know what is, boss, your education is absolutely useless. Can you imagine a tomato vendor comes and says, I'm a tomato expert. Tomorrow tomato prices are very high. I cannot sell anything else. Her three kids will starve to death. See, as we get more educated in a country like ours, we become more and more narrow in our thought process. So we use the very good term called expertise. Absolutely bull. It's the opposite of expertise. We have become more and more less useful to society in many ways. I think it's where that's why, I mean, a lot of people in my office bolta hai, boss, aur ek IIT banda ko nahi lene ka. Ek nearly duba diya, do jan ko nahi lene ka. Irma, or my other colleague is in Irma, boss, oh, bahut kaafi hai. Because I had terrible issues with IIT interns. They blew up systems, they've like done, nahi sir, ye to padhaya nahi gaya tha. Aray boss, this is a classic statement from an IIT, and it's written in red in the office, padhaya nahi gaya tha. Right? So, I'm bola, boss, koi street vendor ke paas jayega, padhaya nahi gaya tha, bolega to. That is where I think, so we have now 600, we have 60 officers. Most of my colleagues out of 600, 595 come from the client base themselves. And I stepped out in 2014 along with Thomas. We had a foundation which we created saying that we have 20 years of experience in Karnataka. We have done enormous number of failures. 99% of the time we have failed. We don't want other youngsters in other parts of the country or the world fail, repeat the failures that we do. So we created a foundation to create the ecosystem in Northeast and in Orissa, Jharkhand. But also we're mapping those issues to how can we create an ecosystem for Ethiopia, Tanzania, and Sierra Leone, because these are the three countries we believe can be hubs in those areas, and map it out like Sierra Leone to Manipur, Ethiopia to Orissa, and Tanzania to Meghalaya. And that's the solution paradigm that we're, and breaking the boundaries that, yes, there are certain set of people who are in Manipur. Yeah, we hold an Indian passport, but the problems are very similar. So let's not come up with an Indian solution or an Ethiopian solution or a solution for Tanzania. How can the poor in the world actually, where you can come up with processes that can go across the south from here to Tanzania to Brazil and vice versa from Brazil to here, for example. I mean, just to example, I mean, once you get deeper into the economic strata of our society or any society, there are so many that should, just like when you start study for an exam or an entrance exam and you get up at 3 o'clock in the morning because you have not been able to solve a problem, that excitement is there in this. Because it frustrates you, and the only way to motivate yourself is those frustrations. If you're not frustrated, you can never be motivated. And those are problems that no Google search can actually help you with those solutions. Google nahi aayega solutions. You have to go down to the field and solve it. And that, I think a lot of my colleagues are brilliant in. And so we mapped. So in 2014, we purposely said that none of us will be there, the so-called people who came from the elite schools. It's, and when I and Thomas left in 2014, the company did much, much better after that. And it grew at a much faster pace than both Thomas, and that's why we said, well, no more IITians and no more Irmans. And these guys took it to a different level, where Mohan, who's a Yakshagana artist by profession, Yakshagana is a folk art in rural Karnataka, he runs a 600-man organization. Interesting how Professor Tony Sheldon, who is the master of social entrepreneurship in Yale, will call him every semester before he starts a class, Mohan, does it actually make sense? I'm going to teach this course. They have a Skype call, this guy will disagree, and that then Tony will change his schedule. Unfortunately, a lot of my colleagues who are known outside the country, not in the country, because in the country, the respect is not there, frankly speaking, because they do not come from a qualified. But absolutely, MIT, Rob Stoner, deputy head of the MIT's energy initiative, would call Mohan and Guru Prakash, right? But if I go to an IIT, Madras, which I go to, or anywhere, Kharagpur, inka degree kya hai? Kill the whole concept of what it is. You lose the essence of how do you solve a problem. It's not about a human being. And mind you, I've had issues both with IIT Kharagpur. It's like that, and that's why I'm telling you, youngsters are, it's a brilliant place, the country. You have enormous problems, but start using your brains. The easiest thing that you'll go and do after graduating is McKinsey and Deloitte. That's the easiest thing that you will do. Don't do the easiest thing. Because in our own, this room of 35 people, if each one of us came with 5 solutions on a yearly basis, you, in 5 years, you'll solve Delhi's problems. Multiply that, this country's problems are not many. But the issue is not what, it's like if you go to an IS officer, oh, government nahi karti hai. It's not true. There are numerous champions in the government who says, but Harish, sab log aate complain karne ke liye. But if I tell, okay, aapka solution kya hai, blah, 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 karke peeche chala jaate hai. Right? And that is where I think be solution oriented, doesn't matter where you actually come from. And yes, madam, you had a question.
So actually, when you started this journey, so there might be some issues like from where you will get the product or from which area you have started, and what are the like first product or first solution you might be having some back of that from where I will get those products and how to set up. So there must be some break even that up to when the profit will be coming.
So no.
How the sustainability of the model?
Sustainability of the model will automatically come provided you have a good grasp of what the problem is. The issue is today we jump into Excel sheets, jump into Facebook and Twitter thinking what the problems. First, I was immerse yourself in what the problem is. Own the problem first. Completely own. It's not somebody else's problem. It's your own problem. Mere ghar pe light nahi hai, mere ghar pe. Okay. Can I come with a solution? What are the multiple solutions that can actually come? Can I do one tomorrow? One house. I want to know what does it feel to talk to a sugarcane farmer versus a paddy farmer versus a street vendor? I have no idea. Right? It's not the product. The people are going to install the product, right? Do I know why they need the product in the first place at all? That mapping I have not done. I don't feel that. Why should a street vendor get this type of light? How do I define a product? See, once you define a product that you have decided on behalf of the end users in many ways. No, I think that's the difference between needs and wants. You break it into two parts, needs and wants. Wants are the product thinking. In terms of iPad, phone, which uses the expendable income of the people that you buy. I'm now talking of the category of the needs, the basic needs. And how do I look at basic needs? Basic needs are something that people pay out of their non-expendable income. And that is always done from a trust basis. Lighting, water, education, health, those are all on trust basis. And that for that is not about product and break-even. Break-even and sustainability will automatically happen once you start owning the problem, coming with the solutions, and what is the appropriate steps to deliver the solutions. Focus on the processes. the financials will follow, right? Today, many of them jump into the financials without understanding what the product is. How do I know a product for a banana vendor is very different to a street vendor? The best financial lesson a street vendor has told me that 300 rupees a month is expensive, but 5 rupees a day is fine. Sorry, 300 rupees a month is expensive, but 10 rupees a day is fine. The issue for her was her money is on a daily cash flow. So it was not the product, it is a financial product, right? Bank will say, boss, I cannot do daily collection. Do you know an average street vendor, whether Delhi or Bangalore, spends 15 rupees a day on kerosene and candles? That's 450 rupees a month. You and me don't pay 450 rupees a month, leave alone kerosene and everything else, right? Normal lights. So four lights, can you imagine you're paying 1600 rupees for four lights? We basically created an entrepreneur who put up a large solar system on his house, 30 batteries, charges those batteries on a daily basis, delivers those 30 batteries to the street vendors at 6 o'clock in the evening, takes 10 rupees from them, they're spending 15 rupees on kerosene. He has taken a loan equivalent to 6 rupees per battery. So he's making a profit of 4 rupees. So I've not used the word climate change, I've not used the word poverty, I've not used the word subsidy. It's how do you put these? So the product is what? The product is the entrepreneur, the bank loan, the mechanism of delivery is the product, right? That is what I say, are you able to look at, like for example, if I go to a paddy farmer, you have to create a loan of 5 years where the cash flow is only in January because his harvest is in December and he has cash in January. So once a year he'll pay. Peanut farmer twice a year, a school teacher on a monthly basis, a doctor on a monthly, rural doctor on a monthly basis. Who are the champions? Who are the pioneers in the village who can actually sway the people or anywhere else? Who are the opinion makers? So you look at that point of time, rural doctor, postman, father of a church, imam of a mosque, priest of a temple. These are all places where you go, you talk to them, what... It's basically how do you, if you come to Karnataka, and this my colleagues have done. I mean they, that's why I say I got all the awards because I speak English, and it's the credit of these my colleagues who've done these brilliant innovations. If you see how they tackle media in Karnataka, you'll see a lot of news items on Selco, none on linking Selco to solar. Selco says that the art of Yakshagana needs to be nationalized. Selco says that the schooling system has to change. Selco says the tax on these have to be there. Selco has encourages that more schools have to be created, or Selco says that the paddy farming has to be re-looked at. None on solar. So suddenly after 15 years people think Selco is part of society. Because it's always linked to that they are providing solutions in the newspaper for any other problem of society. Right? So for example, a girl... a father called one day and said, do you remember you put up a system in the early 90s and my daughter is getting engaged, so congratulations, but there's a problem that she doesn't want to get married and she wants to talk to you. And she's telling, can you convince my father why I should not get married? Because my husband's, to-be husband's house does not have electricity. Do you think I should raise my kids the same way I was raised for the first 8 years? So convince my father why I should not get married. Gives the phone back to the father. Then father says, don't tell anybody, I'm going to pay for the system, go and install in husband's house. My daughter's life is in your hands, and he hangs up the phone. After we installed the system in the husband, she went and got married. That's the connection a lot of people started having with Selco one way or the other. And that is what leads to that trust. And businesses can be created that way. That you don't have to first jump into what is the money that you're going to make. And that's why we started, I don't know how many, we started the same year as Lehman Brothers. We still exist. Lehman Brothers don't exist. Right? So we're saying that sustainability, and so that's why it's not about break-evens. It's how do you define break-evens, right? So once you define a break-even, you're blindly selling systems to people who actually don't need it. Right? You can create a profitable business. You can a sustainable business. So tell me, how many street vendors have you ever heard about going out of business? How many street vendors have you said, okay, what is your break even? Why? Why don't we write case studies on street vendors? They are the best social entrepreneurs in the world. They deliver product at the most affordable price to the most poorest of the poor on the street, and you never hear them. Nor do they have an MBA, but look at Malia. Look at any other business, like none of the airlines make money. There's something wrong with the way businesses are seen and glorified in many ways, right? Our whole lessons have been learned from this basic hardcore street vendors. How do they do business? They take 10% morning if you go to any market, which starts at 4 o'clock in the morning. When they buy the raw material, there's a money lender that gives them money 1,000 rupees. He takes 100 rupees back immediately. That's the interest. That's 11% on a daily basis. That's 3,000% on a yearly basis. None of us would do business, even with all the degrees that we have in the world, right? She takes that 900 rupees, buys the vegetables in Bangalore, goes to which part of Bangalore, whether it's South Bangalore where the Brahmins live, she buys an X amount of vegetables, North where the North Indians and the Christians and the Muslims, she has a different, that in fancy word we saw market analysis, right? Then at evening when she comes back, she has to do, she has no refrigerator at home, she has to decide a pricing strategy, and after all that, she has money to give back that 900 rupees to the money lender, 100 rupees hafta to the police guy, 100 rupees to the cart rental, and there is enough money to feed her 3 kids. How does that happen? And doing better, how many of us are here, the street vendor is not going to come from tomorrow? We hardly hear about that. So businesses are alive and kicking, and many of these that we don't want to case up because angreji nahi aati, right? Oh, case study utna Uber ka bare mein likhenge jo make every street vendor in Delhi makes more money than Uber, because Uber is lost and these guys are surviving on their own, right? But I think we have created a society which has divided, and that's why we are not able to articulate the problem. And that's when, coming back to the topic of science, so the issue is, you look at water, you look at energy, you look at education, you look at health. Each of these categories has immense potential. For example, a dental chair, a simple thing like a dental chair. Dental chair has 150 features. Because it has 150 features, we put it in a large hospital which guzzles electricity. Even if you give free dental services to the poor have to spend 2 days of their time, bus fare, etc., etc. It's actually not free for the poor. It's, your transaction cost is free, but not for the poor. If somebody had designed a dental chair with 4 features, DC powered, we could have delivered dental services right at the doorstep of the poor at 150 at the cost. Why are baby infant warmers absent of less than 1000 watts? What are all the electrical engineers in our country doing? Sewing machines, 400 watts. Simple fan, the average efficiency of the world of fan is 30 watts. Average in our country is 70 watts. Where has engineering gone? Because it's not sexy enough like an app to work on. Hammer mill, blacksmith blowers. How many of you have ever read about what is the technology needs of a blacksmith blower? We have not touched a blacksmith for centuries. We have not even looked at what technology needs a blacksmith blower needs. A butter churner. I gave this problem to IIT Kharagpur. High efficient butter churner. Two months, koi answer nahi, main phone kiya, bola kya, sir, aajkal lot of people are not interested in social problem. I said, that was an engineering problem, not a social problem. Because they could not design a 20 watt motor to run a butter churning machine, right? That's the fascination. You look, you go and walk from here to the market outside of IIT Delhi, you have 10 problems that you can solve with the existing education that you have. And that can be scaled up across the world, but that's not sexy enough for us to solve. But they are hard, complex engineering, financial and social problems. And that is where I expect all of you to actually integrate yourself as not as, what do you call it, as specific, area-specific experts, but cross-cutting into many ways, because this country offers and nobody stops you. Nobody in this country stops you except ourselves. I'll tell you finally before, when a police guy came, I wanted police guy, we call people from different areas to come and speak in our office. also to give a different notion to the youngsters that government is not bad, the police guys are not bad, the tehsildars are not bad. So the police guy gave a classic example. He said, boss, once I stopped a guy crossing a red light. And he said, kya, red light dekha nahi kya? Sir, red light dekha, but aapko nahi dekha. That is the problem of our country, that we don't hold ourselves responsible. Right? We're the only country who can make a one-lane system into a six-lane anytime. Right? So let's not blame the government does not do it, I have other barriers, etc., etc. I'm sorry, none of us have any barriers. And more you say at the elitism of education that you have got, I'm sorry, what will the street vendor say? Sir, how do I get, I'm just like this, similarly, I am Bangalore like last week. Sir, Bapma kya bolenge? Bapma kya bolenge? What will father, parents tell you? Boss, do you, ladki khojte samay to Bapma kuch nahi bolne wale, na? Right, but iske samay aapko bolne wale, right? So we all have an excuse to hide behind something. Right? And that's where, and if I am Bangalore or I am Ahmedabad guys complain about can I take a risk, and you want the poor of this country to take the maximum risk and the most education to take the least risk, where will this country develop then? Right? So I think loan hai. I said, boss, don't give me a bull. I am Bangalore has a specific program. If you get into this industry for 2 years, your loan will be muffed. But we hide behind ki nahi karna. It's an excuse ki kya hoga, government puche. Nobody asks you. I think Champion Asa, there was a kid who joined me and then the parents came and said, sir, Selco, social, shadi, cousin aunts more. I said, I closed the door and said, sir, how was the traffic? He gave me a, traffic was so bad, nobody is improving. Like, sir, I said, this is the problem. You're the problem. You want Gandhiji to be born in neighbor's house, not your house. We all want. I think we need to take responsibility of the problems that exist as a world. I'm not telling India anywhere else. But India is a perfect R&D lab for rest of the world. So rather than be a superpower of military, let's be a superpower of solutions. Where a guy from Togo or Brazil say, I want to go to India because that's where the solutions were created. Central Lahore person want to apply for visa and say, boss, I want to go to rural Orissa and say, a solution was solved. I want to have Lahore in a better position. I want to go to Ahmedabad and see how the slums in Ahmedabad can be a better place for Lahorians to actually copy. That is what we should create this country for. And that's in a very, very small way we want to use Selco as an organization to push that thought process. I think questions answered. Thank you.